Welcome to the class 10 students. This is the continuation part of the chapter heredity and common genetic diseases. In my previous video I started with the topic of monohybrid cross and I performed a cross. I hope you have understood that, and I have done that in the online class as well. So I hope you will not face any problem with the monohybrid cross. And then we are going to talk about the law of Mendel that is derived from the monohybrid cross. Now Mendel gave a few laws which were based on which he performed these crosses. Okay, so now we are going to talk about that law of Mendel that was means on which this cross that we did, the monohybrid cross, is based on. Okay, look at your book, page number 148. There you will find Mendel's law, the topic named as Mendel's law. So the first law of Mendel, known as the law of segregation, this law states that factors for contrasting characters in a zygote do not blend or contaminate with each other, but segregate and pass into different gametes and offsprings randomly. So there in the monohybrid cross we saw that the hybrid tall plant, although it had the gene for dwarfness, means hybrid tall was basically a capital T small t, right? So if one generation, what did we get? We got a capital T small t hybrid tall. Here although the dwarfness of the plant was not expressed anywhere, later at the end in F2 generation we found capital T capital T, capital T small t, and small t small t, these three types of characters. Okay, so although it this small t was not expressed here or expressed any time till this point, in the next generation it was expressed as a pure dwarf plant. So that is what Mendel tried to say, that factors for contrasting character, factors means genes for contrasting character in a zygote do not blend, they did not mix with each other, means we did not get a third type of variety by mixing the gene for tallness and gene for dwarfness. So they remained separate, only that capital T was dominating over small t, that means tallness was so dominating over dwarfness that it did not let the dwarf character be expressed, and thus the dwarfness was there but it was not expressed. So they were segregated and passed into different gametes and offsprings randomly. Okay, now I hope you have understood this law needs to be learned very very well, because separately Mendel's law, first law, or name the law of Mendel, this the name of this law is law of segregation, because here these are being segregated and later on this is being segregated totally from the tall gene and it is expressing itself. So that is why this is known as law of segregation. So these names, the name of the law as a whole, and the monohybrid cross needs to be performed very very well or learned very very well. Okay, I will help you with another type or another monohybrid cross. So let's do that. Okay, so let's start the second problem based on monohybrid cross. So here we are going to perform a cross between a violet color flower, I'm just writing violet, and white color flower of pea plant. So everything is about pea plant. So who are the our organisms among which we are doing we are going to do the cross? A violet color flower and a white colored flower. Now from the seven pairs of contrasting characters you will have to remember, among these two, among these violet and white, which one is dominant and which one is recessive. This violet one is dominant over white. Okay, you will have to remember that violet flower is dominant over white flower and it is a recessive one. So how are we going to do the problem? Let's start the problem. we will write like this. This is the exact particular way how you will do the problem. Previous one I just showed you. I didn't give the introduction, I just explained how to do it, but now I am giving you the introduction, and so you will get to know how to do. Okay, so you will write, let capital V be violet and small v, so always demarcate small v and capital V like this. This is small v, be white. So if it is a violet flower, how are we going to write it? Capital V, capital V, cross small v, small v. This is the P generation. Okay, capital V crossed with small v, small v. Okay, I demarcated small v like this and capital V like a normal. Okay, now we are going to find out the gametes of this. What are the gametes? Capital V, and here the gamete is a small v. Okay, now at that we found out the gametes of these two organisms. We can write here pure violet and we can write here pure white. In bracket you can write it. Okay, now what are we going to do? We are going to fertilize between these two. What do we get? We will get capital V and small v. This is the F1 generation. We are going to get F1 generation, capital V and small v. After that, what is going to happen? You will draw below. Here we are going to write self fertilization. Okay, now after self fertilization, what are we supposed to do? I will rub it and I will do it again so that you can understand it better. Okay, so this was our self-fertilization, means this was our F1 organism. Okay, now to find F2, we will write F2 here. This is the F2 generation that we are talking about. Okay, what are the gametes? I missed this one previously. What are the gametes of this one? The gametes are capital V. And sorry, this is capital V and small v. Now from here you will do the self-fertilization part. Okay, self-fertilization. Capital V, small v, capital V, small v, do the male female. So what are we getting? We are getting capital V, capital V, small v. Again capital V, small v, and small v, small v. After that we will do the phenotypic ratio equals to violet flower is to white flower. So how many violet flowers? 1, 2 and 3 violet flowers is to 3 is to 1. Next you will write genotypic ratio equals to capital V is to capital V small v is to small v equals to 1 is to 2 is to 1. This is how you are going to write. Okay, this is the conclusion. Okay, let me tell you another thing here. When you are writing, means when you are just adding these two gametes to find one organism, here obviously both are capital V you can write, but here one is capital V and one is small v. I am always writing capital V first and then the small v, because the dominant one will always be written at first. We will never write like small v and then capital V, never. Okay, remember this, always capital V will come first than small v. Okay, so this is how you are going to do the monohybrid cross. This is exactly how you are going to write. All the details I have written by doing the introduction. By this I missed in the previous one. First means after the F1 generation you will find out the gametes, just like the previous stage. You will find capital V and small v, and then you will do the self-fertilization. So I hope this is clear to you all. In my next video I will start talking about the dihybrid cross. Okay.